For those in our audience who maybe are not as familiar, how would you define a hydrostatic drive, and how, if at all, does it differ from other drive technologies utilized in the mobile equipment industry?
Yeah, great question, Sarah. And it's one that I get often when I say I'm in the hydrostatics business. Folks look at me like, what is a hydrostatic transmission? I think the best way to describe it is to compare it to a mechanical transmission. Many people are familiar with that, whether it be in their vehicles or on highway trucks and things like that, where your prime mover, most of the time it's an engine, is connected mechanically to your drivetrain, to your wheels, typically. And those are shafts and gears and all those fun things that are efficient, but take up space and sometimes don't work very well in off-highway equipment. So, simply said, a hydrostatic transmission is basically a pump and a motor that's coupled via hydraulic hose. And fluid from the pump flows to the motor, and turns your wheels in a very simplified fashion. There's some advantages of that in off-highway equipment, particularly as you think about the architecture of many vehicles. They don't lend themselves well to having an engine, close enough or in the proximity or orientation to the wheels for propulsion, where mechanical transmissions work very well. And so hydrostatics address that need and give equipment operators the flexibility to design equipment how they might need it. There's some other advantages of hydrostatic transmission, which is it's a shiftless transmission. I can go from no speed to full speed without shifting, right? That's smooth, that's easy on the operator, less work, less wear and tear. I can also go from full forward to full reverse very quickly. Again, no clutching, no shifting, which makes it quite nice. And then I have lots of torque available to me at rather low speeds. I don't have to find the right gear. And I find that sweet spot. And so those are the big differences between hydrostatic transmissions and let's call them mechanical transmissions. And I would say that that looms well for other types of transmissions. And so as you might imagine, based on that value or that value proposition, they're quite widely used in off-highway equipment.
And so is Danfoss seeing a trend towards, greater use of hydrostatic drives and mobile equipment applications then, or due to some of those benefits or advantages they offer? And if so, maybe what's driving that?
We do. We see growth in the market, and I'll say it comes from two areas. One is in equipment that uses hydrostatic transmissions. Those platforms are growing, or those applications are growing. For example, compact track loaders, combines, wheel loaders, telehandlers. Those equipment are growing sort of in the share of population because of their advantages in the marketplace. And tractors, too. I forgot to mention that tractors, particularly smaller tractors, use them as well. So there's growth there. But there's also growth in areas where hydrostatic transmissions haven't been used previously. In part, maybe they've had a more a typical mechanical transmission with torque converter. And we see those in applications like wheel loaders, for example, are now, particularly in North America, are transitioning more to hydrostatic transmissions, where platforms that haven't used transmissions are looking at the full value proposition for the operator. That could be productivity, that could be fuel savings, that could be, efficiency in how they do things, and then sort of that operator comfort piece. But that's one example. In wheel loaders, we see the same trend in some of the smaller tractors. We see hydrostatic transmissions being used in larger tractors now for those same benefits, and other platforms like telehandlers that operate in rough terrain and need precise control and movement. It's quite valuable.
Okay. And you said you're mostly seeing this growth in the North American market, correct? Is there a reason for that versus maybe other regional markets?
And my specific reference there in North America was for wheel loaders,
Okay.
and historically, and the reason why that is historically, the North American market has had a higher population of mechanical transmissions. Europe was earlier to adopt hydrostatic transmissions in
Okay.
some of their larger wheel loaders, and that's sort of an end user preference that they like the feel and control. And now I think the value proposition is for users in North America has become higher. They like the functionality. Maybe some of the duty cycles are changing a little bit for them, that we're seeing that being adopted more in North America. So that's really more just a we tend to see some the equipment operator or the OEMs would tell you that, from region to region, there's things that are important to a customer in a vehicle. And that was one of the nuances in wheel loaders that Europe had more hydrostatic transmissions than what North America had in this case, anyway.
Great. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me today. I really appreciate you giving insight into hydrostatic drive technology and how you guys are seeing it being utilized in the mobile equipment industry.